good evening. How's everybody tonight?
Excellent. Got the bass crowd tonight, so it's a little rowdier. Watch your wallets. So glad you're here tonight. And I don't want to get too philosophical here at the beginning, but I want to quote one of the greatest musical minds of the 21st century, Meghan Trainor. And obviously tonight it's all about the bass, all about the bass. And what an incredible concerto it is. So Dr. Foley and I have been colleagues for 18 years. We've been friends for probably 8 of those years. Sadly, it was the first 8 years. And our lawyers are talking, I'm not sure exactly what happened, but the first 8 years were great. And you know, we'd go golfing and anyway. Mark, it's about time you performed again with the orchestra. And he was excited, and I think he sat down and thought, what do I want to perform? There's not a lot out there for solo bass. So somebody like Mark, who can do so many things, I'll write one. And it's an amazing piece of music. You are going to, obviously tonight is the world premiere, so you're going to be the first public folks to hear this. It's an amazing piece of music, and of course, virtuosically played by Dr. Foley. There's a long list of things this man does, and that we don't even know about. It's Thursday night, and frankly, we're lucky that we have him here. Thursday nights, he scrimmages with the men's basketball team. Don't do it now. During intermission, I want you to Google Foley defense. Foley defense, it's famous. A lot of the college coaches around the country are employing the Foley defense. So we're lucky we have him here on campus. This summer, I want to say three and a half, almost 4 months, he was a backup dancer for Taylor Swift. Was all over the country performing. And again, just such a modest man that he would never share. Probably the thing that I'm most proud of, he designed the brand new Kansas license plate, that gold and blue. So not everything he does hits the mark, but you will be delighted with him. We're going to bring him out soon. Second half, this is perfect weather for an English symphony. The second symphony, the London Symphony by English composer Ralph Vaughan Williams. In a nutshell, Ralph Vaughan Williams, probably best known for his choral music, but also was very tied to the common everyday people. He wrote music specifically for amateur choirs, for amateur singers. He wanted his music to be widely performed and spread. A romantic, he in more ways than one. He took his wife to Berlin for their honeymoon, and it was an extended stay, which on paper looks great. Except at the same time, he also studied with composer Max Bruch. So I guess, you know, leave your wife in the hotel room and go study for a few hours. I'm not sure how that worked out. But perhaps a bit of a late bloomer as well. At age 35, he studied with French composer Maurice Ravel. So was somebody who was tied into, focused on lifelong learning. He always wanted to improve. This symphony is a great example of that. It's probably one of his most revised works. It's also the work that he conducted the most in his lifetime. And it could have been through all of those concert performances where he got to thinking, if I take out a couple bars here and put a few things. So there were two major revisions after it was premiered in 1914. But you're going to love this symphony. Tuneful, dramatic, just really speaks to the heart. Please help me welcome our soloist and first composer tonight, Dr. Mark Foley.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.